Okay, so one of the things that they talked about in this training all weekend was the sense that the greatest gift we can give to another person in a healing relationship is our presence. That really the skills come secondary to the presence that you offer yourself. And when I had my shoulder surgery 4 months ago, obviously I didn't want anyone to touch my shoulder as far as body work goes, but anytime anyone just placed their hand on my shoulder, even if it wasn't with the intention of, directing energy into my shoulder, the amount of healing grace that came would wash over me just from the simple touch was profound. And I know I'm not alone in this, that we've all had the experience of even touching our own head, right? Just kind of our own part of our body that's hurting, that we can offer such incredible healing presence to each other just by being present. So I think our yoga practice is just such a beautiful way of helping us cultivate this. I don't think it's so easy to cultivate a sacred presence. It's not something that our society really values. And we have to kind of push against the grain to bring ourselves into present moment awareness as much as we can. So I think our yoga practice does this, and I would love to hear from you. And I want to read something to you. So before anybody wants to speak to this, either in the way, in whatever comes to mind, I just wanted to read this quote. And this quote was given to me this weekend as a quote by Albert Einstein, but I looked into it and it's not a quote by Albert Einstein. It's a quote by Bob Samples, who wrote a book about presence. And he kind of surmised some of Einstein's work, well, things that Einstein has said, and put it into this quote. So it's not a direct quote from Einstein, but it's about Einstein's musings. So the intuitive mind is a sacred gift, and the rational mind is a faithful servant. We have created a society that honors the servant and has forgotten the gift. And, I think this is very powerful. I'm going to read it again. The intuitive mind is a sacred gift, and the rational mind is a faithful servant. We have created a society that honors the servant and has forgotten the gift. Imagine a world where children who come in so intuitively into our world were taught to maintain that. If we all were taught throughout our whole lives to trust our intuition, to live in that the beauty of the sacred present moment, if that was cultivated deeply as just part of our culture. Imagine for a moment, close your eyes and just imagine what you would be like, what the world would be like if everyone allowed their intuition to be their guiding light. If we used that left brain, that rational, beautiful, rational brain as the servant to the intuition instead of the master of our days. And this is a bit of cultivating the sacred presence. All right, so if anyone has anything to offer to share about a way in which this has landed in you, a moment where you. All right. Anybody else have anything to say about an experience with sacred presence? All right. Well, let's go ahead and find our way into our practice. So close your eyes. And even if you're not sharing with, I know you're thinking about something, right? There's been a moment in your life where you've either been able to offer a sacred presence to another, or you've been able to offer that intuitive mind to yourself to be able to have it be the leader. Or maybe you're thinking about a moment when someone else has offered that grace to you. Whatever you're thinking of, let's just have some gratitude. And then think about what helps you develop your intuition. What helps you develop a sense of this sacred presence? Because intuition kind of lives within this sacred presence. Does your yoga practice help you? Does being in nature help you? Does music help you? You know, what is it? I'm just rattling out some ideas. What are the things that really help you settle into sacred presence? Stillness, meditation. So many things can help us. See if you can just drop into that feeling now. Feel your body. Kind of scan through your layers where you notice your physical body in presence. Your breath in presence. The way the mind can kind of drop and settle into the awareness of the body and breath. Maybe you feel a sense of opening around your heart space or your throat, your third eye, or anywhere in your energy centers in your body. Yourself to start to feel that grounding nature. So maybe scan down through your spine until you get to your sit bones, your pelvis, your sacrum. Maybe even through your legs. I know we're sitting, so whatever feels like it is a grounding force in your body. Bring a sense of lightness into your spine. Can you feel both that balance of the heavy and the light, the groundedness and the expansiveness, stability and the ease, all these seemingly oppositional attributes, but really melding together, they form this capacity to have this type of presence we're talking about. Your breath to be free and move well. Melt into your skull bones. See if you can feel a sense of space in your sutures, in the space right below your skull before your brain starts. Just letting your brain itself soften. Relax through your face, soften inside your ears, base of your skull. Relax your eyes behind their lids. And even if you find some twittery movement of your eyes, don't worry, just settle as best as you can. And as you are ready, place your palms together at your heart and offer an intention here. Place the hands and find your way onto your back. All right, so as you stretch out and lengthen, see what you can do to keep practicing the art of staying present with your breath and with the sensations of your body. These are two, tangible things that we can kind of have as touch points in our mind, body, spirit to ground us to the present moment awareness. All right, so as you lengthen out, maybe stretch your arms overhead and feel that beautiful weight. And maybe you want to stretch one side and then the other. And maybe this kind of automatically gives you the sense of wanting to squeeze or yawn. And follow instincts in your body. What if you didn't have a map and nobody like me was going to tell you what to do next? This is kind of to Christine's point that we kind of need both sometimes, right? We need to listen to the inner guide most of all. But then also, sometimes it's helpful to have a little bit of direction from the outside too. We get accountable by showing up to class. We get help along the way by sharing in community and having someone kind of just guide. But mostly, focus on what your inner guide is telling you. It's the most important voice of all the voices that you hear. It's the most important one to listen to. All right. Bring your knees into your chest and let's rock a little bit, kind of swaying from side to side. Right, and then let's circle your knees, kind of rolling, breathing. Relax your skull, soften what you can. Let your breath get exaggerated if you want. Long, stretched out exhales, or maybe just switch sides if you haven't yet. Or maybe just a big swoosh of a sigh on your exhales, whatever feels like it's going to release some tension and get you here and now. And then let's open up the knees away from the center and bring them back in. And as much as we're focusing on the breath, we're also focusing on the sensations of the body. Let's be kind and respectful and give our body good messages of love and care. All right, right knee into your chest, left leg stretching out long on the ground. And let's now move in our ankle joints and our feet, getting some flow of blood and some loosening of all the tissues in there. Heavy head, stay inside your breath. And go ahead and bend your left knee. Put your right thigh over your left thigh and draw those knees in toward your chest. And you can be very still, or you can pump a little bit where you can draw your knees toward your chest and then release them away, draw them back in and release them away, or maybe some circling or rocking side to side. Sometimes movement, especially in the beginning, can be very good for opening up tissues in the body and joint spaces in the body. All right, then let's release that and open up to a big star on the ground. Spread your wings. Let's roll your wrists and wiggle your fingers and roll your ankles and wiggle your toes. And then knees into your chest and feel your background pick up your head. And then hold your left knee into your chest, right leg long on the ground and give a good squeeze of that knee. And again, start feeling into the movement of your ankles and your toes and then all the bones and joints in your feet. You might feel this all the way up into your shins and the peroneal muscles on the sides of your calves and the backs of your legs where your calves are too. All right, and then bend your right knee, put your right foot on the floor, cross your left thigh over your right thigh. Draw knees toward the chest and decide whether you kind of want to do a little pump of maybe even taking the foot down all the way to the ground, knees back in, or much more subtle than that, just a little rocking. Kind of find pathways of movement. Subtle, big, whatever feels good. Make sure you're breathing.
All right, and then stretch your limbs out like a star again, reaching your body. Open and close your fists, maybe a good squeeze and then a release, and a squeeze and a release. And as you squeeze your fists, now squeeze your legs and your glutes and your back, and then release, and then do it again. Just a few rounds of that kind of pendiculation where we have a little squeeze and release. And then when you're ready, bring your knees into your chest, pick up your head. All right, and then put your head back down. And relax your arms straight out to the sides like a T. Take your feet hip width apart or wider, see what feels good, and just windshield wiper your knees left and right. Just kind of feeling into kind of, you know, moving up the body, starting with the feet, and well, I guess we didn't start with the feet, but just moving up now into the spine a little bit more, feeling some movement in our hips. Maybe we can feel it in your SI joints or your spine. And spread out like a star again on the ground, reaching outward. And then exhale. And you're going to take your right elbow and your right knee toward each other and then let the rest of your body roll over and around into a ball. And then we're going to inhale and stretch out big again. And our exhale takes our left elbow and left knee toward each other and then round over that. And just find that sense of a big open body as we kind of go from one side to the other. I find this to be so much easier on a bare wood floor than on mats and rugs. But be where you are, obviously. But no, if you ever want to try this kind of slithering technique, you can do this on your kitchen floor or, you know, wherever you have a bare floor. And then after you come around to the left one more time, whenever you finish with that left, let's stretch out on the ground and find that big open star again. And try to relax in your star as best as you can now. Breathe deeply. Feel how much contact you take up on the ground. Let your head relax. All right. We're going to bring our knees into our chest. Round your spine a little bit. Put your head down onto the ground. Grab onto your feet. And let's find a little bit of rocking in happy baby pose. If the feet are too far away, grab behind the knees. Okay, and a little bit of rocking. See if you can feel that your back can just release. It doesn't have to be a lot of movement. It can be very subtle. And then come into stillness and just fold your feet and draw them down toward the ground. And then one more time, relaxing, open, spreading and stretching into a star. And then knees into your chest and roll over onto your side and come up onto your hands and your knees. And notice, especially if you have not moved yet today, like let's say you've gotten up and went right to working on a computer or something and you haven't moved your body. Notice even just the simplicity of warming up can have profound impacts on our mobility. All right, so let's start to move through some cat-cows here, feeling your spine open up, finding your breath. Come into that present moment awareness. What is your body feeling like right now? How does it feel to ground your hands? Feel your weight on the ground. Move any way you want to move. So, you know, sometimes slowing down our movements can be a really good way of feeling sensations in the body, and sometimes quickening up. You know, everybody's a little different in how we kind of ramp on into the somatic awareness. You know, how do you like to dip into the river? Do you like dipping into a still river? Do you like dipping into a faster current, you know, just find different pathways to help you get here and now. And then stretch back towards child's pose and settle your hips toward the heels. Walk the hands strongly forward so you open up through your shoulders. And let's rock a little bit here, maybe bearing a little more weight into the left leg, a little more weight into the right, and just kind of find that feeling of a little bit of flowing from one side to the other. And then settle into stillness in child's pose. Transition into dog pose. And remember, everything that I offer is just an invitation. It's not a direction. So always make your practice your own. To me, this is one of the greatest gifts of being at home, you know, and doing online yoga, is that you don't have the expectation of people around you that you have to follow and do anything. So you do you, always you do you. And let's, if you're following me, let's reach up into dog pose and see what kind of movement you want here. Do you want to drop the heel down? Do you want to kind of knead your hands like a cat? And, you know, what kind of feels good in your body to let this pose work its magic within you? How is your breath? Do you have support systems in place? So remember, we're always seeking that balance of stability and ease. So it's not like throw all your alignment information out the window. It's kind of let that be living in your body so deeply that you can, I always liken it to playing an instrument, that you have to learn the chords and the finger placement or whatever, you know, whatever you're doing, you have to find those things first, and then you find the freedom of improvisation. So you're all very experienced yogis. So lean on your skills so that you can improv into your breath and into your awareness. And we'll come forward when you're ready. Come to Uttanasana. Feel free to wag your tail, rock around in your head. Feel that sense of ease. What kind of movement wants to live here? Do you want to bounce a little bit or sway? Is your head free? Are you ready for more stillness? Come into a halfway lift. Again, hands, I have them on blocks. You can have them on your legs, wherever you find them. But feel free if you want to pedal your feet here. If you want to move, try movement. If you want stillness, find stillness. Most importantly, find your breath. Hold and melt again when you're ready. And let's find our way all the way up to stand. Remember, we've been head down for a while. So if you need a little blood pressure reset, squeeze to the midline. Okay, and we're going to reach up with our arms. Have a lift of the heart. Lift your head back just a little bit. No crunching in the back of the neck, but a sense of lifting to the sky. Heart open and expansive. And let's cactus the arms and feel the back body, get a good squeeze, a good awakening, like what's back there, feel what's back there. And then exhale and round in, forearms come to touch, feel those shoulder blades spread apart now. Inhale, one more time, reaching up, a little bit of a heart lift. What are you lifting to? Can you feel your neck relax here? And then let's squeeze the back body again. Cactus those arms, pull the elbows back. Give a good hug of the back body. And then exhale and round in, forearms come to touch. All right, and then let's release our hands down. Give your hands a good shake. Okay. Find your breath. And take your feet hip width apart or maybe a teeny bit wider. And let's start to do some of this movement of swinging through some twists. Okay, so you can let your heel lift. You can let your arms just swing and be fairly passive. Start to invite some engagement of your obliques. So we're kind of churning through the belly, protecting the spine a bit with your core. It doesn't have to be extreme. Let your hips move. How's your breath? Start to feel like this can help you kind of pump your breathing too, to get a little bit more expansive in those lungs. Now we're going to reach the arms out to the sides. The heel is going to lift so we can swing into the twist. Feel free to let your head follow or not. And then the arms up. Finding that movement. Make sure that you feel good in your lower body. And then we're going to start moving down towards some squatting as we do this. Arms up, and you can slow the pace down. You can pick the pace up. This is what I mean by, how do you slip into the stream of awareness? Do you need something a little more vigorous? Do you need something a little more still? Right, get deeper into your squats now. Maybe take your legs a little wider. If this makes you dizzy or you don't like it, do something different. And then back, we're going back through now, arms up, legs a little straighter, and arms out. And then arms down. How's your breath? Find stillness. Be in a good stance. What's comfortable for you? Can you feel your heart beating? Can you feel the fullness of your breath? And any tingles or feeling of awakeness in your body that you're noticing? Can you sense into your feet? Can you release any binding around your diaphragm? So let your body breathe deeply. We're going to start to rock up onto our toes and back to our heels. And again, everybody's pace in this is a little different. Our feet are such an important part of us feeling that sense of grounding. And if we want to seek intuition, if we want to seek sacred presence, I would say that feeling grounded is a really important aspect of this. Okay, so feel your feet, all the muscles in your feet, the muscles in your calves. Let's just wake up a lot of that awareness as we rock onto our toes and onto our heels. And then now that you've got some good blood flow kind of going down there, stand and spread the bones of your feet really well. Try to get your toes. You can even look down at your feet and just notice, like I just noticed that my feet weren't even to each other. So maybe that's, you know, you've adjusted something to find that sense of stability. And once you feel that, feel the four corners of your feet have roots. Each of them, each of those 8 points have a root that can drop down. Now feel the trunk of your tree. Unlock your knees. Feel the strength of your legs. Maybe a teeny bit of engagement. You can even practice just bending your knees a little bit more. See what kind of turns on in your core and in your pelvis and in your legs. Can you feel that sense of stability and ease, balance? So find your breath again. Notice where tension might be living. Let your diaphragm be mobile. Imagine yourself breathing down the layers of your body. The diaphragm lives in the diaphragm. The diaphragm lives in the pelvic floor. The diaphragm lives in the knees and the ankles, even in the soles of your feet. move a bit now. So finding that reaching of the arms up to the sky, the extension and length. And then let's float forward and fold. Let your back open up. Relax your neck. Interlace your hands behind your head. Gentle, gentle tugging. So let the back line open up. And then hands on the blocks. And feel that extension into space. Thigh bones back. Heart extends forward. Melt with your breath. Let's start moving with breath here. Inhale. Lengthen out again, half lift. Exhale, fold forward. Let's repeat that one more time. Feel how the breath can help us live in present moment. Expanding open on the inhale, folding deeper on the exhale. Let's step our left foot back, come into a lunge. Open up through your heart. And let's start to feel that breath take us into presence. As we straighten the leg and as we bend the knee. Hey, how is your pace? What naturally flows within you? See if you can follow your breath. Let the breath be the leader. See if we can, imagine that your intuition lives inside your breathing and the mind, is that rational servant. But our breath is the leader. And you're ready to find a grounded lunge. Maybe you don't want to find a grounded lunge and you'd rather just keep flowing there. That's fine. But if you want to follow me, rise up, crescent lunge. Remember that we're always seeking stability and then the sense of freedom. Okay? The breath links the two. Rely on your knowledge of where your body needs to be in space. And then also rely on this present moment. How is your body in space? Do you need to adjust anything? Do you need to relax anything? Do you need more support somewhere? How is your rhythm of breathing? Let's release the hands down. Back foot comes forward. Hold deeply again. Find your breath pattern. A halfway lift on that inhale. Exhale and fold again. Stepping your right foot back. Left foot is in front. A lunge here. Feeling the rhythm of your breathing again. Straightening the leg a bit or a lot. Your choice. Bending. So you always get to decide how deep you go somewhere, how long you stay somewhere, whether you decide to go somewhere or not. The most important thing you're doing is finding your breath, letting the intuition reside there, listening to the deep places instead of the habitual places. Ground yourself, feel your lunge, feel the roots of your feet drop down. When you're ready, arms can come up to the sky. Feel the rooting, feel the lifting and the opening. Neck soft, find your breath. Where do you need to shore up some support? Where can you find a sense of rest? Do you have freedom flowing through your breath? Remember, it doesn't matter what pose it is, that the shapes that we create are just the avenue for getting present in our body. Hands down, let's come back into dog pose or any other posture that feels right. Feel into the reach, the heart lifts to the pelvis, the hands and the feet spread and ground. Let your head melt. Find your breath again. Forward into a plank. Hold yourself steady here. Find that integration of your core. And find the ground when you're ready. Find the floor Roll the shoulders a few times so you have this freedom of mobility in the neck and the shoulder blades. Lift up to a cobra when you're ready. How does this feel in your body? Is there something you can change to make it better? Melt and relax. Take a different variation if you want. Any kind of back bend that feels free and supportive in your body. Make sure you're moving with your breath. Third time. What's the pathway you want to take? Come up onto all fours when you feel ready. Wag your tail around. Feel the movement. Maybe some circles through your hips. Maybe some wiggles through your shoulders or head. Move back towards child's pose when you're ready. Walk the hands forward. Pause the breath here. Can you feel it travel down your spine? Come up to all fours. Reach your left arm all the way up in the air. Find that open heart. Exhale. Slide the shoulder down and twist. We did a lot of mobility twisting before. This is our first kind of static hold of a twist. How does your breath like it? What can you do to let the breath live in movement within a shape that is a little constrictive? Inhale, reach that arm back up in the air, hand down onto the ground. Let's switch sides, arm lifting up. Exhale, sliding that arm under. Create the mobility of your breathing. Rest your head down. Now reach that arm back up in the air. Hand down onto the ground. Find all fours again. Maybe you'd like to do some cat-cows. Maybe you'd like to move through a dog pose. Whatever you're finding, rest your head, soften your brain a bit, your mind a little bit. Keep searching for the breath. If you're in dog pose, walk your feet forward. If you're on all fours, come to stand. And we'll all meet up in a standing posture. Let's take our legs wide apart on the mat. Come deep into a forward fold, so knees bent, so a deep squat, but your torso's leaning forward. And let's just get used to having some wide legs and drop some weight into one foot and then drop some weight into the other. Check in with your feet, your ankles, your knees, your hips. How are your joints feeling? Open up those inner thighs. Push your knees away with your elbows a little bit. And then come all the way up to stand. Again, whenever you go down and come back up, if you have some challenge with regulating your blood pressure, you can always take those transitions a little bit slower. Okay? And by slower, I mean if you're all the way down, grab your blocks and pause halfway here so that you're in a modified half lift. Hang out a little there for a moment. And maybe put your hands on your hips, hang out there for a moment before you come up. So make that transition to up and down slower. One of the best things we can do to train our system, our vagus nerve, really, to be able to tolerate the ups and downs is to actually do the ups and downs. But you have to modify them until you get to a place where your blood pressure is in good shape. Okay. All right. So reach up. The other thing that helps me with that up-down stuff is making sure that I'm hydrated before I practice. If I'm dehydrated, my blood pressure will drop low when I stand. And if you struggle with that, maybe have a glass of water before you start your practice. Bring your palms together at your heart. Have a moment to center here with your legs nice and wide. How's your breath? Turn your feet out wherever they are most supportive and comfortable. Let your wide stance give you this deeply grounded, supported feeling with the earth. Put your hands on your hips. It can either be fists on your hips or hands on your hips, whichever feels more comfortable. And just take a moment to lift the heart and feel the power in this posture. Back to kind of that inner sense of knowing, inner sense of confidence. Part of developing intuition is developing confidence in it, that we have to trust. All right, then when you're ready, if it's comfortable, reach your arms up, five-pointed star. And expand outward in all your limbs. How's your breath? Relax the base of your skull. You might want to turn your feet out now if they were pointing straight. Take a deep breath in. We're going to travel down, 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 bending the knees. Arms follow. So feel that energy dropping. And then we're going to lift it back up. Imagine your hands are kind of sweeping through the energy centers of your body. So clearing whatever needs to be cleared as you drop down. Maybe you can imagine kind of sweeping the floor where you sweep out whatever is no longer needed, give it to the earth. And then draw something from the earth back up and sweep that through your body. Now, maybe my pace is too slow. Maybe my pace is too fast. Again, you go into the river how you want. And then follow the rhythm of your breathing. And now, next time we get down there, find a comfortable place to stay. So you don't have to go super deep. You can be higher. That's maybe a little more sustainable. And we're going to reach our arms out, and then we're going to bring them back in. Do this however feels natural to you. Follow a pathway of gathering. Feels good. Feel a pathway of expanding. That feels good. Your arms might go up overhead. Whatever feels good to you. Let's end this with a rounded, deep lunge, but our arms are open. Spread open the bones of your feet. Now pump here a few times. Just pulse. Full breaths. And then a nice big stand up. Standing star. And then bring your arms down at your sides. Now this next one, we're going to flow again. And you guys have done so many variations of this with me, and I really want you to find what feels good to you. So it could be that you're flowing over to one side and coming back over to the other. You could do some big sweeps upwards, some big sweeps downward. Maybe you stay low and your arms can kind of float out. Don't think at all, okay? Drop into your body. Bend your knees as much as you feel comfortable. Try not to just live in the straight leg sticks, because sometimes bending into our legs will help us ground a little deeper in our lower body. So even if it's just a little bit of bending your knees and finding flow. So don't look at me. Close your eyes if you can, or look at something that is very steadying in your room for you. So I don't want you to follow me. I want you to, maybe I'll stop moving so you can't follow me. Just center into yourself. Find your breath. Whatever movements are feeling good, remember to get your legs in there. So we're not just living in the upper body. Live in the torso. Live in the legs. Live in the sides. Live in the shoulders. Live everywhere. mostly live in your breath. And then again, when you're done, wide legs, straight legs, palms together. Let's heel toe your feet in till you get to the point where your legs are more neutral. Full breaths. The mudra of your palms together can be very centering. But if you'd rather do something different, do something different. And our way to the ground now. Maybe a big sweeping up with your arms and a melting forward. Let your back relax. Maybe a little shimmy, a little shake. Maybe very still, a halfway lift. Maybe pedaling your feet or moving your body, maybe very still. Relax and fold. Bring your hands and knees onto the ground. Maybe a little bit of movement of your spine. And then eventually finding stillness in child's pose. Feel the squeeze in your knees. Feel the compression in your hips. Feel the length through your spine. Put your arms whatever place you want them to be. You can rock and move. You can be very still. The most important thing you're discovering is your breath. Pigeon pose or reverse pigeon pose, whichever feels better in your body right now. If you're coming into pigeon pose, support yourself in whatever way you need. If you're in reverse pigeon pose, maybe your hands clasp behind your hamstring or the front of your shin, or maybe you grab a strap and wrap that around your knee. Whatever feels best. Opening up your hip. Relax your head, soften your diaphragm, release any tension from your shoulders. If you're in pigeon, make sure your head is supported on something. Again, do you want total stillness? Do you want a little bit of movement in there? The most important thing you're paying attention to is how your body is breathing. Now, I could have just as easily guided you through all restorative poses. We could have stood in Tadasana the whole time. We could have done some salutations the whole time. The shapes aren't what matters. It's the what you dive into, how you bring yourself into awareness. And obviously, certain poses do different things for our sense of where we are in space and how we're opening our body. Let's switch sides and what, you know, parts of us feel good by doing this, that, or the other thing. But ultimately, the shapes are there, the poses are there to bring us into our bodies. We don't use our bodies to do the poses. We do the poses to get into our bodies. So are you here and now? What can you do to melt a little more into the here and now. What are you sensing? What are you noticing? Are there sensations that you're trying to get away from? Are there sensations that you're diving into? Try not to have judgments about things that you run away from, but just be curious. Place ourselves out of that posture, and everyone's going to find their way to your back if you'd like. And let's first just find some neutrality. Maybe you want to pick up your hips I've been doing this a lot lately. I think it feels good, but only if you feel it feels good as well. Ground your feet, lift up your hips into like a low bridge and just shake, 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 shake. And like let your intestines shake around, your ribs, let your lungs jostle. Relax and melt toward the floor. Let's do a twist. Hips over to the right, knees up and drop left and open the chest. Feel into your breathing body. Melt your head as best as you can. Go ahead and find center. Move over to the other side, hips to the left, knees to the right. Breathe deeply. Find your way back and decide how you want to be right now. Do you want a moment of Supta Baddha? Maybe your knees can support, be supported by blocks. Maybe you're going right into Shavasana. Maybe there's something else you need clearing out in your body. Let's start to find a sense of weight, sense of release. Again, let your breath travel around. The only reason we breathe is to get oxygen to our cells. So imagine the cells are doing the breathing. Your whole body gets to receive your breath, even if we just feel it coming into our lungs, all the way down to our toes, all the way out to our crown, all the way to our fingers. We receive this beautiful oxygen, this prana's energy. Let your whole self receive. Whenever you're ready to find Shavasana, if you're in a different posture, maybe you can let your body find the comfort of Shavasana now. Of melting, letting your limbs get heavy and sink, your head heavy and sinking. Smooth your face muscles, let them all relax. Let the temporal bones around your ears soften, let the spaces inside your ears soften. Your jaw. Slowly begin to deepen your breath again. And start to move your body however you want, however feels right and good.
Coming onto your side and up to a comfortable seat. Place your hands together at your heart and let's feel this centering again. Breathe well. Let's offer this gift of our presence to someone. Namaste. All right, everyone. Thank you.